Whoopi is stepping on an airplane for the first time in over, what, a decade?
Yeah.
Tonight, when she heads to London to work on the stage production of Sister Act. And she is absolutely petrified. And we are doing everything we possibly can to make sure she gets on board with the clear head, which is why we pretty much built an airplane in the studio and asked Virgin Atlantic to help her out with their course, Flying Without Fear. So please help me in welcoming course director Richard Conway. Welcome, Richard.
Hi, guys.
Okay. So why don't we explain for Richard, how did this fear begin? What was the genesis?
I saw in 1978 a mid-air collision.
That'll do it.
Yeah, that pretty much started the ball rolling. And okay. So everything from then on was about all I could see, because I'm a visualist. I saw it every time I got near a plane, when I'd hear a plane.
Okay.
And then I'd get on the plane, and then it whatever it was doing was suddenly attached to that. And it was about, for me, watching in slow motion something happen. So
Especially having that image in your head. Is that something unusual? Do you hear that a lot, Richard?
Well, everybody's different, so it's different things that we have. But the Virgin Atlantic Flying Without Fear program deals with thousands of people, helping them to overcome their fears of flight.
Okay. So what happens does it start when you're in the airport? What happens when you get on a plane?
It starts the days before.
Okay.
I start to panic, I stop eating, I shake, I lose temperature, I get pale, which is not cute.
So you haven't seemed like yourself, I will say.
I've been thinking about it.
Yeah, you've been a little off.
And I've been trying to get away from it, you know, because it's paralyzing. I mean, 12, 13 years I haven't been on a plane.
It's a long time. So what do you do? What calms you down? Anything?
It used to be about 80 milligrams of Valium and a lot of alcohol.
Okay.
But the problem was, it never affected me.
Calm you down or kill you.
No, it never affected me because the adrenaline is so high in me that it blocks everything. So it's not until I land do I get the sensation of having 80 milligrams of Valium in my system.
Okay, so you have the after effect. What about, like, professional help? Hypnosis, doctors?
Seen lots of people, talk to all kinds of crash specialists, and, you know, because people, either they understand it or they think it's foolish. You know, I would love to be somebody who just sat on a plane and went to sleep.
Me too. You know? I'm not that person either. Yeah. I mean, once in a while I will. But so, Richard, when you hear this case, what is your course about, and what are we going to do today?
Okay, well, what we're going to do today, in fact, first of all, I must tell everybody and the viewers that we had Whoopi yesterday, so to speak. We had Whoopi yesterday and helped her. Our course normally takes about 10 hours.
We
did it in 5 hours. Yeah. We've got there as well. We've done very, very well.
Good.
Now, today what's going to happen is Captain Dominic Riley is going to answer some of Whoopi's questions.
Okay.
And then our fantastic psychologist, Jill Harvey Bush, she will actually be helping with some techniques and tactics.
Great. Well, we've got some friends on the plane back there. Hi, Joy. Hi, Sharon. We're going to walk on back and get started, right?
Let's go. Okay. Off to you guys.
All right. So we're going to board the plane. You feeling okay, Whoopi?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, baby.
Let
me sit here where it is.
Here, I'll go here. I'll be okay. I'm moving a little while.
Okay.
Okay, so we're on board.
Please do belt yourselves in.
Okay. Don't forget to buckle up.
He's on his way.
Love traveling with them. Okay, so you have Captain here with you, right?
We do.
Captain Dominic?
And I'm now going to hand you over to Captain Dominic.
Great. Oh, there he is. Captain Dominic, we need help.
Hello again, ladies.
We've got a level 10 fear of flying candidate right here, so.
We did a lot of work yesterday with Whoopi. Nice to see you again, and hope you're feeling a lot better than you were yesterday.
I actually am. One of the things that the anxiety that I have because of what I saw, Captain Dominic actually put it to rest, because aviation has evolved so much since 1978
and continues to
that what I saw virtually cannot happen again.
Okay, so the things that specifically scare you, like when you're on the plane, when you feel something, is it like a shake? Is it a...
No, it's the whole package.
It's
you can't isolate it. It is all of a piece.
Okay.
And so it was really extraordinary to actually say to somebody, you know, I think I'm going to get on the plane and not be ice cold.
Okay, so you seem fine now.
Yeah,
sure. Simulation, you seem pretty good because we're still
on the
ground.
Simulation.
We're gonna take off in a little while next segment, but we want to make sure that you feel good for the entire time. She's making progress though, right, Captain?
Tremendous, yeah.
Okay.
Very confident.
And you have... In terms of the plane remaining in the air, you know, we feel turbulence. Turbulence is something that freaks me out. I always think something bad's going
to
happen.
It's the single biggest problem we have to fear to face with our clients. And it's so easy to sort out because airplanes wobble. Turbulence is all around us. It's always going to be a little bit of motion. That's what airplanes do.
It's annoying when you call it just a little bit of turbulence because to us it's not a little bit. It's a lot.
It's perception. There's no such thing as bad turbulence. It's not going to bring the airplane down. Okay. The airplane's not going to be in any danger ever. So it's fine.
Okay. And then you also, I don't know if you met her yet, but you have a psychologist here, Jill, who actually has some techniques that we can use to help us feel more calm. Okay, great. Hi, Jill.
Hi.
Thanks for coming.
You're welcome.
Okay, so you actually have physical techniques that you can show Whoopi to make her more calm on the plane, things that she can do.
Absolutely. We used a range of techniques yesterday. Okay. One was neuro-linguistic programming, which is a lot of visualization. Okay. But the main one we used was something called thought field therapy, which is a tapping technique.
Okay. So do you do? You just tap somewhere?
We tap on specific points on the body and a specific sequence.
Eyebrow.
Okay.
And then there's a finger.
Yep.
Why finger?
One finger.
And then it was a little finger.
If it was Queen Elizabeth, you couldn't do that.
No, you could briefly tap.
Discreetly tap. And under the arm and onto the collarbone. And it's actually...
You might freak the people around you out, but you'd be fine. You'd feel better.
We're getting the whole world tapping.
Okay, good. So we're all going to tap. So do you mean you're going to tap away?
I will tap and I'm very excited. I have to say, you know, this program doesn't exist yet in the U.S. We're trying very, very hard to get it here because I think lots of people would benefit because, you know, it's hard. And if you don't know who to ask or turn to or say, I need some help with this, you feel like you're out there by yourself. And for me to say... You know,
it's a big deal.
You need to bring this program here because I just feel like I got a huge amount from it.
Yeah.
You know?
Fantastic. Yeah.
I'm gonna get on a plane.
Well, I think many people feel the way you do. And I think even down to like those tapping techniques, if we can find them through your website or even ours, that would be amazing in terms of helping other people. Are there things that Whoopi should avoid the day of the flight? Are there things that increase anxiety,
absolutely,
like caffeine or?
Yeah, we found some individual energy toxins. We called Dr. Roger Callahan.
Keep yourself in the future.
She should avoid smoking on the day of travel. We've given her a sequence for that addiction as well.
Okay.
And stop smoking then?
Because it can actually affect the treatment. Perfumes, laundry powder, things like that can be actually quite
toxic.
So
no stimulants, just everything kind of calm and relaxed.
It's different for different people. And corn was the other thing for Whoopi.
Yeah. Corn?
Yeah, anything with corn.
No corn chips. Okay, well listen, hold on to your seat because when we come back, Whoopi is taking off for a test flight live on our stage. Keep your seatbelts fastened.